this day, but I know you've come this day that the Lord will answer your prayers and that you'll go back with something new. There is nothing else that we need but on the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Come on, just begin to speak to your Father in heaven, surrendering everything into His mighty hands, because He alone can heal you. He alone can write off the story, the sad story that you had before. Come on, with every eyes closed and hands raised, just begin to speak to your Father in heaven. Talk to your Father in heaven. The only thing He wants from you is only openness. He wants that heart of yours. Lord, you are worthy. We thank you because you're a good God. We thank you because, Father, you started with us, Lord, from way back, even before we came out from our mother's womb. You planned everything, Lord Jesus, for us, Lord. And Lord, we are no more beggars, Jesus, but we are royalty, Lord. We are no longer prisoners, but we are running free, Jesus. Every bondage, Jesus, we break in the name of the Lord. Jesus is all you need. Jesus is all I need. Come on, just raise your hands in the air and sing this chorus there. And Jesus, I need you every moment. I need you here now. Jesus.
Whatever you have in the baskets ahead. Our ushers, may you please help us? smartphone, eh? If you have a smartphone, I want you to pick up your smartphone. If you have a smartphone, just pick it up and wave. If you have a smartphone, so most of the people here don't have smartphones. If you have a smartphone, please pick it up and wave. I'm going to ask Cedric, pick up your smartphone, take a selfie. Take a selfie. All right, Cedric, you come here, we'll take a selfie. Pick up your phone, take a selfie. The lights, please, media team. All right, you can post it on you can post on Twitter, and the hashtag is #standout. The hashtag is #standout. You can post it on Twitter. You want your friends to be part of this because we are live streaming. Now, without much further ado, without much, it's X. I've been updated, and it is X. So, without much further ado, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, dudes and dudettes, let's put our hands together as we welcome Bob!
All right, thank you. Thank you very much. How are we doing this evening? How are we doing this evening? All right, cool. So hopefully we are going to be having a very good time, but I can assure you that we will be having a very, very fantastic conversation this evening about time is everything, okay? And we have some amazing people who are going to help us really unpack this topic today. But to begin, I just want to really begin by, I think the theme today was inspired by Ecclesiastes 3, okay? And verse 1 says that there is a time for everything, a season for every activity under the heavens, okay? And the verse goes on to give us a time for this and a time for that, a time for this and a time for that. But also we understand that in life, in everyday life, you know, timing is very, very important, okay? And today we're going to be very, very punctual. There are certain aspects of life where you cannot avoid to mess with time. It's just all about timing, okay? And so today, we have two amazing people who are going to help us really understand in their own life journeys, to help us reflect in our own lives as well. Where moments when we had to seize the opportunity, okay? Moments when timing was literally everything, okay? And so, to help me do this, I'm going to begin by inviting my, our panelists for the evening. As I said, today I have two amazing panelists, okay? And the first person joining me up here on stage is the girl from Oyam. How many of us are from Oyam? If you're from Oyam, by show of us, make some noise, young people. All right. The first one was young people, okay? Sharon Okello, please join us up on stage. And let's make some noise for her as she comes over there, okay? And I will get to know a bit more about herself in just a moment, okay? And then the second person here that is going to be joining me on stage is filling in very big shoes, okay? We're supposed to be having someone who sent things to space. But we realize that it possibly dropped in from space to later. We are going to have, in this half an hour, we're going to have Cedric Otolo. Very good. I'll be asking you some questions about space since you are you're filling in big shoes, okay? So here's what's going to happen. I'm sure there's going to be a link or some way for you to ask questions as well. So as the conversation goes on, feel free to drop your questions, okay? If you have the chat app, you can use that as well. If you don't have it, what are you doing with your life? Download the app, okay? Ask the questions from there. We'll be able to get those questions as well. And since we're talking about time, we are going to dive right into this conversation and unpack how time is everything. Yes, let me make sure my panelists all have microphones. Do we have another one for the gentleman from, where are you from? Are you from Oyam as well? I'm on a time, okay? Okay, I'm from Balwana, if you know where that is. Okay, so let us pass. Sharon, just tell us, who is Sharon, the girl from Oyam? I know you have very, very big titles, you know, you're executive director of so many things, and I was reading your CV, and I must say that, you know, in the essence of time, you may not complete me. Okay? But if you can just briefly unpack us now, who is Sharon or Caleb? And you know, when I posted the post today, people, you know, there was, you know, I had my speaker, Sharon or Caleb, and then my name is Robert or Caleb. People were asking, how did you not tell us? So please, let's clear the air, okay? And who is the Caleb? We want to also know. Please.
Thank you very much, Robert. Praise God. Are we all okay? Okay, just to clarify, my name is not Sharon Okello. My name is Okello Sharon Nagendwa, in that order.
All right.
Yes.
All right. I'm safe. Okay.
And that was my late father's name. So my late father gave birth to only, he only had girls. So somebody who was the firstborn had to take over the name, and I did. So I'm just living on with the Okello name for his legacy's sake. Yeah. So Okello Sharon Nagendwa is, I like to call myself a cheerleader of women. My job is mainly to shine the light of the already powerful women who are the youths. And of course, the men. The men, but I am mostly a woman. I'm into woman empowerment, and I like to correct people. I'm not a feminist. I am just here. I advocate for the power of women, to see women move from the stage they are in. I advocate for gender equality and economic empowerment of women and girls. You want me to go through my education background, because that is going to be really, really long. But
just give us, you know, think of the iceberg, right? Or yum, you know, you come from a yum, people are like, this a young girl is not looking like us. So let us also clear the air in that regard.
So I come from Oyam. I call myself the girl from Oyam, because everywhere I go, people keep saying, you don't look like from, you're from Oyam. I say, please. I'm from Oyam, so on Twitter, you can follow me on Twitter and Facebook. I'm the girl from Oyam. Those are my handles. So I am born to Okello Peter the Late and to Akello Hilda from Minakulu. My dad is from Ngai, you know, so both parents are from Oyam.
So young girl already.
Yes, a brief of my education background is that I did mass communication, so I'm a media personality, but then also I'm enrolled in two masters, which is gender, and then also development communication, which is in Daystar University, Nairobi. My work journey has mainly, I started working at the age of 16. So as you see me here, you know that I've been there. I've been where you are. I started working at the age of 16 at a very big organization, and one may wonder how I got there. I don't know if that is what we should be getting into right now. We are into introductions, right?
Right, right.
Okay, we will take the next stage after that.
Cedric, tell us something we don't know about you as your introduction.
My mother and my father were neighbors before. They were in the same school, and then my father met my mom when she was in, I think, P7. Not P7, I think P6. Yeah, I'm starting from what you guys don't know. Then in senior two, she gave up on studies. She said, I'm ready to settle with this young man. And then at the age of around 23, 24, she gave birth to the beautiful Cedric. Guys, clap. So my name is Cedric Otola. I'm a member of this church, and I'm so humbled that today I'm on this panel. Maybe just a little about me that maybe most people don't know is I'm a common person and a simple guy. Today I'm replacing the shoes of one of the biggest guys in this country. Clap again. Professionally, I'm a software engineer, and right now I'm back at school and doing a course called Artificial Intelligence and Machine Learning. At the same time, I also love writing. I love to share my thoughts with people. And on the 7th of December, I'll be launching my third book. In case you are in Kampala, you can join us at Africana Hotel. Okay, how old am I? I'm 25. And then also, I'm a business person as well. I work with a company called Kakebe Technologies, and I serve as a team lead of the company. And then also, I also have another company called Mimba Care Technologies, majorly focused on the mothers. And then also, yeah, it's a long list. But then to cut it short, I also serve as the ambassador for Lion's Den program in Uganda. So it's an honor to be here. Thank you.
All right, fantastic. Now that we know who is up here.
Just to give them a brief, because you had told me not to do the titles and all, but maybe. So I run Northern Uganda Women's Network for Business Development, which has their main office here in Dera, and all other regional offices in Gulu, Arua, and Moroto. We man the Triumph Women Initiative, and then also I'm also in the steering committee of the GROW project, which is the World Bank project currently.
Fantastic. I think that's a very good transition into my first question for you actually. So we can already tell that throughout your career thus far, you've won so many hats, right? From media to wildlife conservation, now into women's advocacy. And most people are wondering, you mentioned that you started working at just 16. I know the public one is maybe 18 because of labor issues. You are being okay. So could you just tell us now, a time in this journey when you had to seize the moment, okay? Did you start working at 16 because, you know, was it a matter of an opportunity that had, you know, presented itself and you had to seize it? Or, you know, when in this journey did you feel perhaps a few moments when, you know, timing was really everything?
So, you know the saying, opportunity comes to the prepared? At the back of your mind, you must know what you want. So growing up, I knew for a fact I wanted to work on TV. I wanted my first job to be on TV. So even during high school, every time I was basically reading the news on assembly, everything was about the media. Anything media in high school, I would put my nose in it. So the time that I seized the moment, when you talk about seizing the moment, it takes me back in history. You know, I lost my dad at a very young age of 5. And My mom was a housewife at that time. But I thank God, God blessed me with another father right now called Ayana Crispas Odon, and I'm very proud of him. He took care of us. So by going back to that moment, I entered a church. And because I was in Mototo, we used to sing. So this time I entered a Mabati church, which was just next to the neighborhood, because at that time my mom cannot afford to now transport us to town to Mototo. And children were singing on stage, and I wrote a sheet. I also want to sing. Immediately, I'm put on stage because the girl in the neighborhood who is so cool, whose dad just passed away, let her give her the opportunity to sing, and I sang. Coincidentally, in the audience there were white people, and then they asked, "Who is that?" Then they told her that girl just lost her father. And do you know the song I sang? You don't have to worry. You don't have to be afraid. That is the song I sang. At that moment, they said, "We're going to pay your school fees." That was seizing the moment. Moving forward to the 16-year-old who wants to be a media personality, who wants to work on TV, I was buying fish for my father. My dad, Ayana, loves fish a lot, dry fish. So my mom sent me to the shop to buy fish. And I went and bought fish. It was around 3,000 shillings. The lady I bought fish from, I give her 5,000, and then she returns 7,000, thinking the 5,000 she has returned is 1,000 shillings. She gave me balance of 7,000. I walked a distance thinking, I'm like, should I take it back or not?
That's a good question.
Yeah. And at that moment, I took something just spoke to me that this is where your blessing begins. I turn around, instead of thinking about the airtime I want to buy to call my friends around, I tell her, madam, here, this is your balance. You gave me extra money. Do you know what 5,000 shillings means to a 16-year-old girl? Yeah? 5,000. By then. She asked me, what do you want? I said, madam, I want to work at NBS TV. She said, you will get it. This money you have brought back was supposed to feed my two children. Today I am a widow. My children are orphans. If you had taken it, we would have no food. Some people like to make time look like a coincidence. I always like to say, time and grace move together. That was my fast. And I entered into NBS TV on Monday, asking for a job. That very day, I started working. Not tomorrow, not the day after, that day is when they said, Sharon, sit there at the reception and start working. That is how I got my blessing.
Wow, wow, wow. Some of those facts me here is, you know, time and grace move together. You tweet that. You see, some of us get tested in so many ways, right? And sometimes, you know, the grace is just looking for you, and perhaps, you know, the blessing is just there waiting for the right moment. And, you know, blessings normally come disguised in so many things, right? And someone told me that, you know, you won't get into a place where your character cannot keep you, right? So something as simple as, you know, taking back the chain, you know, could unlock some tremendous blessing. It's a test, very simple test, right? But for every test, there is a promotion that comes at the end of it, right? And maybe this is also something we need to understand as we are really understanding the issue of our timing. Thank you very much, Sharon, for sharing that. Now, Cedric, yes, again, what is it that we don't know? Tell us a moment, okay? When for you, you know, you mentioned many things in introduction, you're a businessman, you're into IT, you do debugging and stuff like that, you know, timing, okay? Share with us a moment when, a pivotal moment in your life, when timing was everything.
Thank you so much. So, I'm sorry you lost your dad when you were 5. I lost mine when I was 4. Life was really hard at the beginning, you know. But I want to thank God that in 2007, I think it was on the 16th, when I... Hello? Yes. On 16th of July, when I stepped into an orphanage to be taken care of because my mother could not do anything. Now, from there, I started learning about Jesus and everything about God and just trying to understand what does it take to be a child of God, you know. And then I was in P4, but Bob, I remember you shared your story.